Hi everyone, welcome back to Earl Grey Books. I'm Ellie and today I'm here to do my Eurovision-a-thon TBR. So this is a readathon that was created by Helen from Helen's Book Haven. She's lovely, I will link her below, as well as the Eurovision-a-thon Twitter. And everything else that you need to know about the readathon. Basically, it's a readathon in which we try and read books from authors or set in the countries that are participating in Eurovision this year. And there's a point system and whatnot. I will let Helen describe that to you because she can do it a lot better than I can. We're going to get into it because I have 17 books. I should probably tell you when it's running. It's runs from the 24th of April to the 22nd of May. So, let's get into the 17 books. We're going to go through these in alphabetical order in terms of like country, but not in terms of like, they won't be alphabetical once we break down into each letter. Anyway, okay. So a lot of these are just going to have to be pictures because a lot of them I'm reading off Scribd, if not Kindle or my library's ebook service. I only have two that I own. Firstly, Albania. I am reading The English Witch by Loretta Chase, who is an author of Albanian descent. And this is also at least partly set in Albania, I believe entirely, but I'm not sure. Yes, thought I'd throw a historical romance in there. Next up, we have Australia. And I am reading The Boy from the Mish by Gary Lonesborough, because I thought that I would use the Australian prompt to read some more First Nations authors. This is also kind of going to double up for Aussie April. So I thought I'd pick this one. It's a YA LGBTQ plus as well. So really excited for it. I was going to say really enjoying it, but I haven't started it. Next up is Belgium, and I'm reading Nowhere Boy by Catherine March. This is set in Brussels. I believe it's about a young boy who has just moved to Brussels and a Syrian refugee. Bulgaria is The Historian by Elizabeth Kristova. Probably should have mentioned that I'm doing my best with some of these names. So I apologize if any of them are terribly, terribly wrong. I don't really know anything about this one. I've seen it for years and never picked it up, and now I have it. Yay. Number five is Croatia. I am reading The Age of Skin by Dubravka Uregic, maybe? yes, I believe this is like personal essays and things. With this one, I believe the author identifies as being Yugoslavian, but the place that she was born is now considered to be in Croatia. Number six is the Czech Republic. I am going with The Librarian of Auschwitz by Antonio Iturbe. I didn't realize that this is actually based on a true story, so I may kind of talk about that at a later stage. I'm hoping to do maybe like a midpoint wrap up with this. I haven't really decided. Or maybe a vlog. Haven't decided. We shall see. Number seven is my favorite country in the world, Denmark. And I'm reading The Shamer's Daughter by, this is one, Lena Kopperbøl. I don't speak Danish. This is a like children's YA, first book in a four book series, and I'm really, really excited for it because I haven't really read anything like that from a Danish author before, and I'm very excited. And next one is France, and I'm going with, I think it's A or the, one of those, Winter's Promise by Christelle Dubeau. I've seen lots of people talk about this. Kara's read the whole series that's out. I don't know if it's finished yet. I think Lauren read it as well. I have a lot of middle grade on here, so don't know what to tell you. Next one is Iceland, and I'm reading The Casket of Time by Andri Snemagason. This is also middle grade, and I totally screwed that last name, but 10, Italy. I'm going with SPQR by Mary Beard, which is The History of Ancient Rome. May possibly regret this one, but obviously this is on my TBR and I want to try and get it off. I have an entire month, so I think I can do it. I may even, I don't know if this is cheating, sorry Helen if it is, I might start this one a few days before Eurovision starts, just because I feel like once I start it, I'll be fine. But yeah, otherwise I think I'll just panic about it. Okay, next one is Ireland, and I'm going with In the Woods by Tana French because I have been avoiding this one for years. I have had this on my Kindle, I think for about 2 or 3 years, and I technically didn't even have a Kindle when I bought this. I just had like the app on my phone, but I'm gonna do it this time. This is not the sort of thing I like. This is like a thriller crime thing. I don't really like that kind of stuff, but I've heard really good things about this one, especially from people who also don't really kind of like that thing. So crossing fingers that I enjoy it. Number 12 is The Netherlands, and I am reading The Letter for the King by Tonka Dwat. All my Dutch friends, can you please tell me if I said that right? Yes, this one I have been literally, it's one of the oldest books on my like Goodreads wishlist TBR thing, so it is finally happening. I almost bought this the other day too, and then I found it on Scribd, so very happy. 13 is Norway. You may have guessed that I am kind of doing the whole Scandinavian thing. And I have The Mercies by Karen Millwood Hargrave. I believe she's an English author, but that this is set on a Norwegian island community thing. Don't really know much about it, but I saw it was about Norway and I was like, yeah, cool, love it. Next one is Poland. I was trying to avoid reading too many World War II books because I've read that, a lot of that before, and I think there is a lot more interesting history about these places than just that one specific, you know, period of time. So I'm going with an essay collection for this one. This is A Slight Exaggeration by Adam Zagajewski. Yep, that was a guess. Spain, we're going with The Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. I used to own this one and I unhauled it. Managed to find this copy from my library's ebook service. And I'm gonna give it a go. I don't think it's gonna be one that I buy back, but I'm gonna give it a chance for this to see how I go. Okay, second to last one is Sweden, wrapping up the Scandinavian thing, and that is Beartown by Fredrik Backman, because I feel like I'm one of the last people on BookTube to read Frederick Buckman, and I was never really that interested in him. But I do believe that this one is about ice hockey, and I really like ice hockey. So I'm willing to give it a chance. And who knows, maybe I will really enjoy him and want to read more of his, but it's not my usual genre. And then finally, wrapping it up, we have the UK. So I thought that it was, like, you know, a good decent chunk of the books that I read are set in England. I've read quite a lot set in Wales, and in Scotland, and I thought, let's read some more Welsh stuff, because yes, I've never been to Wales, but I enjoy the idea of Wales. And my mum used to live in a town called Ely, which is where the name Ali came from. It's spelled the same way but pronounced differently, because why not? So yes, connection to Wales, love it. And I'm going to go with the selected poems of Gillian Clarke. One of the rules is that all these books have to be over 100 pages to count, and I believe that all of them are. Even in the, like, poetry collections, I've gone for big collections, like entire collections of different poets, or ones that are like essays as well, and all of the children's fiction and everything is over 100 in the editions that I have. So I was pretty proud. I didn't have to change anything for that rule, so I'm pretty proud of myself for that one, to be honest. But that's it. That's the entire TBR for now. I think I'm just going to try and get through these 17. And maybe if by some miracle I manage to do that, then I might look at covering some of the other countries. But that's what I've got right now. And I have a lot of other things going on in April and May. So we'll just kind of see where this is gonna go. Thank you all so much for watching, and thank you, Helen, for creating this readathon and for just being so organized with everything, honestly. And I'll see you guys then. Bye.